Hello, good morning. Welcome back to Space Engineers on the Xbox One. This is the Space Engineers beta, and it currently has some free stuff in it. Some free stuff as a demonstration of Sparks of the Future, which is coming to Xbox One this month. We've recently had Frostbite, but Sparks of the Future is the big game changer. Why is it the big game changer, I hear you ask? Well, it brings with it a bunch of updates, additions. The patch notes are quite extensive. I'm not going to go through them, but I am going to demonstrate a couple of the things. This is my survival save from the retail, ported across onto the beta. And there's something different about this particular atmospheric vehicle that I built on it. It used to use rotors for the back loading bay, but now it uses the hinge block. Look at that. That is smooth. Hinge blocks allow you to do a lot of cool and amazing stuff. I'm really excited to play around with them. And of course, since we're on my survival save, I have creative mode tools active. And if you can't remember how to do that, hold the right bumper, press Y, and just select Enable Creative Mode Tools. It's good for testing. Welcome to my little demo area. Imagine if this is your loading bay, or your part of your bay, and you have your ship's gear with a hinge block, and the new collisions with the pistons, we can do something pretty impressive. So we have a piston set up here with some blocks attached to it. In the old build, you couldn't do this kind of thing, but you can on the new build. What does it do? Well, are we ready? It lets us move that for a start. And the hinge block lets us swing the gear down into place. Now, you could put all this on a timer block, so you press one button and then after a while it triggers the bay to shut. And then a second timer block could be used to reverse the process. I did that on my Century Eagle ship with the landing ramp. I don't know if this is an airtight seal. I haven't tested anything like this space-wise. I will probably do a build to test that, just to see whether or not it does make airtight spaces. I'll do that a bit later on, maybe. But you can do all sorts of things with it. This isn't a tutorial, but to give you an idea of how easy the hinge block is to use, you place it down like this. And if you pop down a button panel, now normally I'd name the hinge block, I'm pretty sure that's hinge 3, and we just pop a reverse on that. I say I'll do a proper tutorial. Right, yep, so that button will work. Now, what we want is we want a bit of velocity to make the hinge work. We probably don't need any torque because And as you can see, it has a lower limit and an upper limit. 90 degrees and minus 90. Swinging both ways. Currently, if you look, it's at 0 degrees. So, all we need to do, find the hinge block. We can type hinge, which will list all the hinges. And then we just need to pop a little bit of velocity. If you want to make your velocity go up in decent steps, press and hold the right bumper, then press the D-pad in the direction. We'll set it to about, say, make it 3. So as you can see, there's your hinge. You can put things on it. See, it's got conveyor ports so that it can be used to create links between all sorts of tubes. And now when we press it, look, it will swap from one side to the other. Now say we didn't want it to swap from one side to the other. We just wanted it to change between one angle. What we do is look at the lower limit. We know it's at minus 90. So we make the lower limit now 0. It'll move the rotor, the hinge. And now if we press the button, that hinge will only go between there and there. And because of the new collisions, in theory, if I've got this right, if not, it won't work. There you go. As long as you're building that block attached directly to that conveyor, you can make those hinges do what you want. As I said, it's not a tutorial. Well, it is in a way. I've been off Space Engineers for a bit, or rather I've been working. I'm back-ish. Like I said, once Sparks of the Future comes out on retail, I'll be diving into that, doing some great stuff. Meanwhile, here is an idea. Imagine this is the deck of a ship. So you're looking at the top of the ship. And you want to deploy a secret. You can actually move now using the collisions that come with the new update. Blocks against other blocks as long as you build those blocks off the piston. And because of that, you can push the floor blocks between other blocks. So you could have a little mini turret that pops up out of the floor as a defensive array on your vessel. That's really all that I've got time for, to show you some of the things you can do with hinges. There's a lot more that you can do. Obviously, the PC has much more functionality because of the ability to use scripts and mods, although with the arrival of dedicated servers, no, I don't know when those are coming, but they are coming. They are testing at the moment. There have been rounds of invites sent out. People on the Xbox One are playing on dedicated servers. If you want to find out more, go to Keen's official Discord or drop my hours on the Space Engineers Xbox One Facebook group Discord. We're only too happy to come and answer questions or at least say hello. We do have Keen there as well, and they do a lovely job. And this game has come on leaps and bounds since launch, so thank you, Keen. Thank you, everybody who supports the channel. I never expected to get to 377 subscribers, because this is just really a little bit of a project for me to mess around with Space Engineers and share what I've learned as we go along. Until then, though, until the next one, which will be fairly soon, I will say bye-bye. for now, take care, stay safe, as always. Happy engineering. See you again. Oh, and it's raining. Yep, that's right. We have weather implemented on the Xbox One as part of the beta. If you don't know how to get the beta, well, all you need to do is open up your game on your Space Engineers, go to the Xbox Official Club, go to the Welcome, choose Change Game or Swap Game, and you should be able to get the beta from there. And the beta is free to anyone who owns Space Engineers on the Xbox One. And you can play around with some of the Sparks of the Future content and enjoy all the stuff. Bye for now.